This is Eve's Various Children by the Grimm Brothers. It's a very short story. It's also quite a biblical story. When Adam and Eve were driven out of paradise, they were compelled to build a house for themselves on unfruitful ground, and eat their bread only by the sweat of their brow. Adam dug up the land and Eve span. Every year Eve brought a child into the world, but the children were unlike each other, some pretty and some ugly. After a considerable time had gone by, God sent an angel to them to announce that he was coming to inspect the household. Eve, delighted that the Lord should be so gracious, cleaned her house diligently, decked it with flowers, and strewed reeds on the floor. Then she brought in her children, but only the beautiful ones. She washed them and bathed them, combed their hair, put clean raiment on them, and cautioned them to conduct themselves decorously and modestly in the presence of the Lord. They were to bow down before him civilly, hold out their hands, and to answer his questions modestly and sensibly. The ugly children were, however, not to let themselves be seen. One hid beneath the hay, another under the roof, a third in the straw, the fourth in the stove, the fifth in the cellar, the sixth under a tub, the seventh beneath the wine cask, the eighth under an old fur cloak, the ninth and tenth beneath the cloth out of which she always made their clothes, and the 11th and 12th under the leather out of which she cut their shoes. She had scarcely got ready before there was a knock at the door. Adam looked through a chink and saw that it was the Lord. Adam opened the door respectfully, and the Heavenly Father entered. There, in a row, stood the pretty children, and bowed before him, held out their hands, and knelt down. The Lord, however, began to bless them, and laid his hands on the first, and said, "You shall be a powerful king," and to the second, "You a prince," to the third, "You a count," to the fourth, "You a knight," to the fifth, "You a nobleman," to the sixth, "You a burgher," to the seventh, "You a merchant," to the eighth, "You a learned man." He bestowed upon them also all his richest blessings. When Eve saw that the Lord was so mild and gracious, she thought, "I'll bring out my ill-favoured children also. It may be that he bestow his blessing on them likewise." So she ran and brought them out of the hay, the straw, the stove, and wherever else she had concealed them. Then came the whole coarse, dirty, shabby, sooty band. The Lord smiled, looked at them all, and said, "I will bless these also." He laid his hands on the first, and said to him, "You shall be a peasant." To the second, "You a fisherman." To the third, "You a smith." To the fourth, "You a tanner." To the fifth, "You a weaver." To the sixth, "You a shoemaker." To the seventh, "You a tailor." To the eighth, "You a potter." To the ninth, "You a wagoner." To the tenth, "You a sailor." To the 11th, "You are an errand boy." To the 12th, "You a kitchen boy all the days of your life." When Eve had heard all this, she said, "Lord, how unequally you divide your gifts. After all, they are, all of them, my children, whom I have brought into the world. Your favours should be given to all alike." But God answered, "Eve, you do not understand. It is right and necessary that the entire world should be supplied from your children. If they were all princes and lords, who would grow corn, thresh it, grind and bake it? Who would be blacksmiths, weavers, carpenters, masons, labourers, tailors and seamstresses? Each shall have his own place, so that one shall support the other, and all shall be fed like the limbs of one body." Then Eve answered, "Ah, Lord, forgive me. I was too quick in speaking to you. Have your divine will with all my children." There's so many interpretations you could take from that. There's so many messages you could take. Oh, yeah. I'm going to pick another story for next week. One fell out. See if I can get it to put that down. It is The Darning Needle by Hans Christian Andersen. And I think that's one of the... I don't know, I recognise the title. It might be famous. It's a really hot day, and I want to go outside. But if you like this, let me know. Like the video, comment. Subscribing is nice. It shows me there are people who are watching. It's pretty useless in the grand scheme of YouTube these days. But it's nice to see that there's people who enjoy listening to these. There's also a link to my Patreon page if you fancy supporting me there. That'll be in the description. But until next week, bye-bye.